Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The And Then There Were None book by Agatha Christie. Arrived in like perfect condition. So excited to have this, and keep for a long time. After all, wasn't that the whole point in making a facsimile edition in the first place? It was good though, and all reading enthusiasts should have at least one Christie novel under their belt. The very beginning has a bunch of introductions, and it seemed like it would be impossible to keep up with who is who since all 10 characters are introduced right off the bat. The only real criticism is that a book with so many characters to develop fully could easily have been lengthened. When you do not know the characters from other books, you are open to just about anything. And Then There Were None had several titles before settling as 10 little people that change ethnicity and occupation. There they find out that there may be a nefarious plot that they soon become aware of. A fast and fun read with few clues along the way to reveal the most logical and satisfactory ending. Very soon after their arrival, each is accused of having brought about the death of another person, and for that they are to pay. Agatha Christie seems to have covered all of her bases on this one to leave the reader attempting to figure out the clues. When the launch leaves them on the landing at the isolated house on Indian Island, they are cut off from the world. Cradled in fear, everyone wants off the island immediately. But there is no way off. With each suspecting the other, they must wait for the launch to show up, or for their own death. The prose is simplistic enough for a young adult reading, and for the advanced reader it's a bullet though a gun read that you won't be able to put down. Lauded as the standard for the whodunit crime novel, Christie's And Then There Were None holds up to the critical praise. By now, however, the trope has been visited so frequently, revisited in film and literature, that the original has lost some of its luster. Agatha wrote this in 1940, so you need to reset your mind to a much earlier era. Most of the film versions have ruined the ending by trying to impose a happy ending. It remains quite simple, and sticks to the formula it presents from the very beginning, but this formula is intriguing and interesting by itself. All stories are what author want it to be, and as there is no information in written words, it's a very interesting concept, and everything is tied up nice and neat in the end. A book that took a genius to plan out as only Agatha Christie can accomplish. Some very choppy dialogue, odd italics in odd places, and parts seem to be missing because of that. The guests are soon confronted with the reason for their invitation. Their host knows about the secrets of their pasts, and has decided that justice must be served. Be advised, this book, And Then There Were None, is the same book as 10 Little Indians, reissued with new title. No doubt later stories and modern-day serials have built on her foundation, and so, to the modern reader, you might get the feeling of it's been done before. The story only works in days of no cell phones, and DNA testing, and what have you. 10 soldier China figures in a house on Soldier Island represents the 10 people that have come to the island. One by one the China figures disappear, but who has removed them? Why does Anthony Marston choke himself, and who is the murderer? And Then There Were None refers to the last line of the poem by Frank Green written in 1869, and then it probably cannot be a secret what the book is about. The book is concentrated on a single spot, the island, which makes the book easier to follow. You don't have to concentrate on the various settings, and therefore it's the question of who the murderer is that gets the reader's attention, and the question that keeps bothering you as the story progresses. They are all brought to an island where they are confronted with crimes they are accused of committing. The original has inspired so many takes, but the ultimate solution here is way more clever than most that have followed since. There was no indication what the outcome may be, although there were some possible suggestions. 10 murders happen in succession without making it look ridiculous or giving away the murderer. It has enough characters to keep you guessing, but not so many that it gets too complicated. The audio version is also very well done and made a long car trip feel much shorter. Slowly, the guests begin dying one at a time, and there is no one else on the island. 8 people get letters to attend a free vacation at a home on Indian Island. This book was spellbinding, a good Agatha Christie for those familiar with her writing, and a wonderful addition to the newly christened Agatha Christie fan. Agatha Christie is also easy to read, with one chapter flowing easily into the next, making it just as hard to put down because of the plot as with the written story. There are some gruesome details, but Agatha Christie writes neatly, and to the point. No scary, put on the nightlight, look under the bed stuff unless, of course, you don't like a murder tale. Good to read at the beach, on the plane, or as a passenger in a car. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe, and leave your comments below.